Congratulations on your purchase of the Nairi KE280 electric knife sharpening machine, which in 2003 won both Catering Product of the Year from Catering Today magazine and featured by Meats Trade Journal in their Best of 2003.
Hi, I'm Natalie from Knife Wizard. This machine will not only produce a very sharp edge, but will also produce a polished, scratch-free finish unique to the Nairi KE280, which also means that you do not have to use your sharpening steels once you've used this machine. The machines are electric, but they're not automatic. There is a degree of skill that's required by the operator. The purpose of this DVD is to show you the key points in achieving good results, although only confidence and practice will allow you to do this. We will also show you how to avoid cutting belts, how and when to change the belts, and how to clean the machine. Please understand that the absolute sharpness is a factor controlled by the hardness and quality of the steel, not by the machine. For example, this standard butcher's knife here has a Rockwell rating of 42 degrees, and it could never achieve the same kind of sharpness as this expensive Ioshen Japanese knife, which has a Rockwell rating of 62 degrees. However, even your less expensive butcher's knife can still achieve high levels of sharpness. Access to the abrasive belts is to remove the top cover by unscrewing the wing bolts underneath. The top cover can be lifted off, exposing the two wheels. The abrasive belts are non-directional, and since we only use half of the width of the belts, the carrier wheels can be reversed when half of the belts have become worn. Do this by releasing the centre butterfly nuts, rotating anti-clockwise and turning them round. It is good practice to clean the machine every time the top is removed for belt turning or replacement using the brush provided. Never use any liquid to clean the machine. To gain full access, slide off the axle drums as well as the carrier wheels and brush over a suitable receptacle, i.e. a rubbish bin. Typically, one pair of belts will sharpen about 100 knives, 50 on each side of the abrasive. Worn abrasive belts can be removed from the carrier wheels by teasing them off or by carefully cutting with scissors. Avoid damaging the rubber cushions underneath.
You can detect that the belts are worn and need reversing or replacing by two ways. The abrasive used, aluminium oxide, is extremely hard and it cuts cool, i.e. it doesn't significantly heat up the steel of the knife blade, unlike silica, which is sandpaper abrasives.
When the abrasive is worn off, it exposes a backing cloth. Cloth rubbed against steel at high speeds will generate friction and heat. Your knife blade will feel warm, but it won't feel hot. Worn belts will also take longer to sharpen your knife, so when two passes in each stage fails to sharpen your knife, please change your belts. As your knives will be in varying degrees of sharpness, we suggest that before you sharpen your store's knives, you take off the carrier wheels with the fine abrasives fitted, which came with the machine, and place the medium abrasives on carrier wheels onto the sharpener. These are the ones in the blue box. This will reprofile your knives far quicker than using fine abrasives alone. Once all your knives have been sharpened using the medium abrasives, refit the fine belts on wheels back onto the machine for future sharpenings. When reassembling the machine, ensure that the centre butterfly nuts are tight and the top cover is correctly fitted. Tighten down the wing bolt nut to secure the top cover. We're demonstrating using an extremely blunt meat counter knife. To show you how blunt, you can see it is incapable of slicing through this tomato without bruising it. Now I'll show you how to sharpen it, but first we must clean and dry it to avoid contaminating the abrasive belts.
The KE280 has two sharpening slots and a central guide. The left slot sharpens the left knife edge and the right. The knives should always be sharpened with alternative movements. There are three stages, each with different reducing downward pressure levels to achieve a sharp edge and a perfect edge profile. These pressures are printed on the top cover of the machine and explained in the written instructions. Stage 1 requires 1.5 kilograms of downward pressure, and if you're unsure how this feels, place the machine without electrical connection on a set of bathroom scales and test for yourself. In practice, you will hear the noise level of the rotation motor vary according to the down pressure you exert. Typically, 12 passes through the machine is all that is required to sharpen your knife. 2 passes on each side at hard pressure, 2 passes on each side at medium pressure, and 2 passes on each side at light pressure. During the drawback process, as well as exerting the correct down pressure, there are 2 other factors to consider. The knife edge must stay tight against the central guide, and the knife should be parallel to the work surface. Lower the knife vertically into the slot, exert the correct pressure for the stage you're on, and draw back smoothly. An 8-inch knife takes approximately 3 seconds to draw back at the correct speed. If the knife has a curved end, it is necessary to raise the handle at the end of the stroke to keep contact with the abrasive. Listen to the noise of the motor. It is clearly under load, but not slowing its rotation speed. Stage 2 requires a down pressure of 0.6 kilograms. This time the load on the motor is slight, you can hear the difference. Finally, and very important, is stage 3. This involves the lightest of down pressure, less than the weight of the knife. We will try the tomato test again. You can see that with the lightest of pressure, the knife now cuts the tomato cleanly. We stress again that knives must be clean and dry before sharpening, and cleaned again after sharpening and before use.
If you mistakenly cut a belt while using the machine, you must turn off the machine immediately and also replace both belts. If you only replace one worn belt, then you will inadvertently alter the sharpening profile of the knife. If you cut through a belt, you have either not correctly positioned the knife into the machine relative to your body. For example, if you're a right-handed user, you need to line up your right shoulder with the sharpening grooves. If you're a left-handed operator, you need to grip the end of the machine here and again drop the knife in so the grooves are completely parallel to your left shoulder. Or you have not lowered the knife vertically into the machine and you've travelled forward into the machine and most likely clipped one of the belts.
The other common error is not keeping the contact point of the knife parallel to the work surface. If your grip is too high, with the knife handle higher than the knife point, the blade will touch the plastic at the front of the sharpening groove and you will not have the correct contact with the abrasive drum. If the reverse occurs, with the handle too low, then the blade will touch the plastic at the rear of the sharpening groove with the same result. It takes practice to keep the knife correctly parallel, and remember, when you're near completion of the sharpening movement, the grip must be progressively raised to fully sharpen a curved point. Do not forget that knives must be cleaned after sharpening.
We hope this training DVD will assist you in becoming proficient with the machine, but please understand that it will take time and practice before you can call yourself an expert and train others. Thank you very much for your attention.